वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट टेंजेंस पब्लिक स्कूल बागपत ऑनलाइन इकोनॉमिक्स क्लासेस पार्ट 4 क्लास 12 कॉमर्स। एज यू नो दैट वी आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम अवर होम, सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 4 मेजरमेंट ऑफ नेशनल इनकम विच इज फ्रॉम मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स बुक। टुडे टॉपिक इज प्रिकॉशंस ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड। इट मीन्स दैट what should be the precautions of value added method while we are calculating national income. See here, first precaution is imputed value of owner occupied houses should be included. What does it mean? Again I am repeating, imputed value of owner occupied houses should be included. What does it mean? It means that People who live in their own houses do not pay any rent. I can say that any rent amount which is not paid out will be called imputed rent. Here is the meaning of value rent. Mark this, rent. Listen carefully. Again I am repeating, if any rent amount which is not paid out will be called imputed value, or we can say imputed rent. Again I am repeating, people who live in their own houses do not pay any rent, but they enjoy housing services similar to those people who stay in rented house. What does it mean? Listen carefully. If any rent amount which is paid out will be called actual rent. But I am saying, if any rent amount which is not paid out will be called imputed rent, or we can say imputed value. So I hope, what is the meaning of imputed rent and what is the meaning of actual rent? I hope it is clear. See, again I am explaining, according to this point, imputed value as well as actual value will be included in national income, or we can say to be included in national income. So I hope this point is clear. See next point, change in stock of goods. What is the meaning of goods? Inventory, or we can say inventories, will be included in national income. Again I am repeating, change in stock of goods will be included in national income. What does it mean? It means that, see here, what is the formula of value of output? Sales plus change in stock plus production for self consumption. According to this formula, we can say that change in stock is a part of value of output, sales is also a part of value of output, and production for self consumption is also a part of value of output. See formula of value of input, domestic purchases plus import. I can say that domestic purchases is also part of value of input, and import is also part of value of input. See what is the formula of GV at MP. All of you know that value of output minus value of input. Value of output formula is here, and value of output is here. See, value of output is a part of GV at MP, is a part of GV at MP, but there is minus sign. There is sign of minus. There is a sign of minus. I can say that value of output is not a part of GV at MP. Value of output is not a part of GV at MP, but value of output is a part of GV at MP because there is a sign of plus which is hidden. See, we know that GV at MP is known as GDP at MP, and GDP at MP included in national income. GDP at MP included in national income. We can say that GDP at MP is a part of national income. GDP at MP is a part of national income. Value of output is a part of GDP at MP. Change in stock is a part of value of output. I can say change in stock is a part of GDP at MP. According to this, I can say that change in stock is a part of national income. So we can say that change in stock should be included in national income. So I hope this point is clear. Change in stock of goods will be included in national income. So I hope all of you have understood all these points. See, after this, first method is value added method, and next method is income method. See, under this method, national income is measured by adding all the income accrue means received. Accrue means received. Mark this. Accrue means received to the factors of production. Factors of production are four. First is land, second is labor, third is capital, and fourth is entrepreneur. My dear students, you know the meaning of capital. I'm explaining. Listen carefully. Capital means all those man-made goods which are used in further production. Again, I'm repeating. Capital means all those man-made goods which are used in further production. For example, machinery, tools and equipment, buildings, all means of transport and communications, raw material, or we can say there are lots of examples. So I hope it is clear what is the meaning of capital. Again, I'm repeating. Capital means all those man-made goods which are used in further production. Examples of capital goods are machinery, building, raw material, all means of transport and communication, tools and equipment, etc. So I hope meaning of capital is clear. See, what is the meaning of entrepreneur? There is another word, enterprise. First of all, we will discuss what is the meaning of enterprise. Then after, we will discuss what is the meaning of entrepreneur. Listen carefully. Enterprise means to start a business and run it. Again, I am repeating. Enterprise means to plan a business, to start a business and run it. This is the definition of enterprise. But what is the definition of entrepreneur? Listen carefully. The man who undertakes all work in business, we can say the man who undertakes all work in enterprise is called an entrepreneur. So I hope what is the meaning of capital, what is the meaning of entrepreneur, what is the meaning of enterprise, I hope Clear. After this, in form of rent. Rent is related to land. Wages. Wages related to labor. Interest. Interest related to capital. And after profit. Profit is related to either entrepreneur or enterprise. For their productive services in an accounting year. Accounting year means financial year, fiscal year, during a given period of time, during a period of 1 year. So all these are same. So all these are same. Accounting year means from 1st April to 31st March. I hope this definition is clear of income method. After this, see, what are the components of factor income? Factor income means income under income method.